Hello folks, welcome back. This video will guide you on how to add shared calendar in Teams. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. You may want to have a shared calendar for your internal team, for your clients, or for your students. Every Microsoft Teams have a SharePoint site underneath to store documents. We can add a shared calendar to Microsoft Teams by using SharePoint calendar app. You can also customize the shared calendar app permission to make sure who can and who can't add or remove entries to the Teams shared calendar. So let's see this in action. I am inside Microsoft Teams desktop application. On the left hand side, you can see there are a few teams created. One of them is year 8 class. So we have a general channel and a history lesson and math lesson channel. So one way to create calendar is you can create a calendar for the channel. So for example, if I'm in a general channel, I can click on this plus sign and then I can search for calendar. So there is a channel calendar you can create. So if I click on that and click add, so this will add this channel calendar to this general channel. Now there are a few drawbacks of using this type of calendar. This is specific to a general channel. So if you want to have a calendar, for example, same calendar in the history lesson channel or in the math channel, you cannot use the same calendar. So you have to create a specific calendar for each channel. Also, all the members and owners of this Microsoft Teams have access to this calendar, so they can add or remove entries. But what you just want team owners to be able to create the events in this calendar, and the members and readers should only be able to see those calendar entries and not able to create one. So to do that, we need to create a calendar inside a SharePoint site, which is created when I created this team. So if I go back to the general channel on the post section, and from the top right menu, if I click on these three ellipses and I can click on open in SharePoint, this will open the SharePoint site for this Microsoft Teams. So you can see that year 8 class is the team and it by default takes you to the document library. From the left hand menu, if I click on site content, here I can create a new calendar for this team. So if I click on new and click on app, now I need to search for calendar app. So it is not on the first page, so I click next. Here I can see a calendar app available. So I click on that. I will just name it. I will just call it year 8 lessons calendar and click on create. So the new calendar is created here. So if I click on that, now this open up this nice calendar in SharePoint. Maybe if I go and create an entry for this date on the 8th, click on add button here. If I say math lesson 9 to 10 a.m. and I won't fill any other information, I click on save. Now this entry is saved here. Now I want this calendar to show up in Microsoft Teams. So I take that link here, copy the link, and I can show that calendar in the general channel or one of the other channel as well. So if I come on the general channel and click on this plus sign here, and then if I search for website, because this is a link to a website which is a SharePoint site, and the tag name will be lessons calendar, and the URL I will paste it here, the link I've taken earlier on, and you can leave this checked post to the channel about this tab. So whenever I click save, it actually notify the people in the channel that a new tab is available. So I'll click on save. Now you can see that lessons calendar is nicely laid out and it is appearing inside the Microsoft team. Now what if you want that only the admin of this team can create an entry and member can only view it? So you can easily change that. So if I navigate back to the SharePoint side of the calendar and I click on that calendar from the tab and go to the list settings, I need to change the permission for this calendar. And if I navigate to permissions for this list, so at the moment this list is inheriting permission from its parent, which means whatever the permission of that team, it is inheriting that permission. So what we can do is we can stop inheriting permission, and I will confirm that by clicking OK. Now this list have a unique permission. Now we can change the permission level for these groups. So visitor is already read, owners have full control, whereas this member at the moment have added access. So we can change the member access to read as well. So if I select the member group and click on edit user permission, here I can uncheck the edit and I can check the read. So this way the people in the members group can only read this calendar and cannot add an entry, for example your students. If I click on OK, now you can see the permission level is read for the members. If I go navigate back to the teams, now only the site owners, the team owners, can add events to this calendar. So you can add the events here from within the team. Click on add. You can just say history lesson and maybe starting at 10 to 11 a.m. on the 9th. Click on save. Now we have added two lessons here. Now what if you want this to appear in all the channels? So if I go to history lesson channel, I can click on the plus sign here and click on website and just call it lessons calendar, and then paste the same URL we copied earlier on from the calendar list in SharePoint. I will click on save. Now you can see that same calendar which appears in the general tab, lesson calendar, is appearing inside the history tab. So we are sharing a calendar from Microsoft SharePoint into multiple channel inside the Microsoft team, and we can also change the permission for that calendar. So as you can see that SharePoint app calendar have some advantages over the channel calendar. So to just wrap up this video, today you have learned how to add shared calendar in Microsoft Teams. Thank you very much for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any questions regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, put in the comment section below. I review user comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.